What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to another MLB The Show 19 Diamond Dynasty video. And today I'm going to be doing something a little different. I'm going to be going over the top three players at each position on the market for guys that you might want to buy, guys that you're looking to pick up. I'll be helping you out a little bit. I'm going to give you five starting pitchers, three for the rest of each position. And then I'm going to go through budget ballers. I'm just going to go through each position and tell you a little bit about what I think you should do on the market. So, top three players. Here we go. Number one that you can get on the market right now is probably the most expensive one, Lefty Grove. Lefty Grove, this card, actually not the most expensive one, behind Felix. But this card is absolutely insane. Look at that. Unbelievable numbers all across the board. Great five-pitch mix. I do not think there's a better card on the board than this. The only reason that there's something selling higher is because this is a 12-0 BR reward, and not many people have gone 12-0 since this card's dropped. So it's a little rare, making it a little bit more expensive on the market. But this Lefty Grove, I mean, that card is an absolute stud. He's an absolute stud. So now moving on to number two. I think it's this Mad Bum, honestly. 98 overall. He's only selling for 46K. So he's also going to drop under the budget ballers list. So, I mean, this card is absolutely incredible. I've had him for a long time, pitched 108 innings with him. He's 16-13, only using his 13 losses because I quit out of a lot of games for, like, missions and whatever. You have to quit out of games. With a 3 ERA and 104 strikeouts. I mean, this card is my best pitcher. I have 99 Kershaw, 99 Nolan Ryan, 95 Wainwright, 93 Wade Ford. But this card is probably my best one on the squad right now. So he is going to fall under number two. And like I said, he is a very, very, very budget kind of player. So that's, I mean, he's a really, really good addition. And I definitely recommend picking him up. Number three is going to be this 96 Zach Greinke. And now I had this card on my team last year. I don't have him this year. He's just a little too expensive for me, out of my range. But again, a nice five-pitch mix with a fastball, slider, changeup, two-seam, and a curveball. And just really good stats all across the board. And he pitches really well. He has really, really good location at 89 control, 87 velocity, 95 break. Nothing too overpowering, but he's good in every single position. Just a complete full circle. If you look in the bottom right, how it has the circle of attributes, everything's almost full. How you know he's a complete player, selling at 102,500 stubs. Pretty expensive. Not as expensive as our number four, which is going to be this Felix Hernandez, who I think is, he looks a lot better than Greinke. The same overall, but I think the Felix looks a lot better. But if you had to ask me who pitches better, I mean, I'd have to say it's Greinke. Greinke pitches better than this Felix Hernandez card. Even though the Felix Hernandez still looks really good. And he's dropped down to number four just because of the fact that he's so expensive. Just a slight bit of me says, listen, you're going to have to spend a boatload to get him. He's going to drop down to number four, but 99 velocity, 96 break, 90 control. I mean, he's topping out here at 98 and then slowing it down to 80 on a sweeping curveball. Sweeping curveball is so difficult to hit. So far we have four signature series here, and now we're moving on to number five. And number five is also going to be a nice little budget baller. I think it's this 95 CC Sabathia. I think this card is very, very solid. Got a nice five-pitch mix. This Burt Blylevin is also really, really good too. I just don't think he's got a crazy amount of velocity. And I just don't seem to pitch really good with him. He's got a huge breaking curveball. But, I mean, two types of curveballs. I don't get that. Not the biggest fan. And I hear so many bad things about this Verlander curve. I guess he just gets rocked. That's why he's not up there. And, I mean, there's just not enough about this Kluber yet. He's only been out for, like, what, a week or two? So, I mean, I can't say anything about him. He's only been out for a week or two. But that is the starting pitcher spot. You know, the top five right there. Now, moving on to relievers. It's just going to be relief pitchers. Number one, man, it's got to be this 94 Dylan Betances. I mean, look at the per nines on this card. The fact that it is not a live series, those per nines are just going to stay there forever. And that it's amazing. The three-pitch mix, throwing 97 miles per hour four-seam and a two-seam. and an 83 mile per hour slurve with 99 break, 99 velocity. I mean, this card is overpowering. I think this is the best reliever in the game that is not a signature series card. And he's only selling for 51,000, so he's falling in around that budget baller territory. So number two reliever is going to fall in the gold category. I think it's 83 Andrew Miller, and I mean, even though he's a gold, I still think this card is absolutely incredible. The slider, four seam, two seam, changeup, four pitch mix. Today he's down on inside edge, but we're not looking at inside edge. The per nine's real good. He's got good clutch. The control's down a little bit, but the break and the velocity makes up for it. And number three, I think, is this Ken Giles. He's really good, too. I hear a lot of good things about this card. Nothing too crazy, but he's just a good pitcher. He's going to get you outs. Moving on to the closing pitcher. There's definitely a lot more options here for closing pitchers. Almost a full page of golds. But I'm going to go to the number one closer. Who do I think is the best closing pitcher in the game? I think it's this 99 Billy Wagner. I'm sorry, but I have to go with the 99 Billy Wagner, and he's only selling for 75k, and he's in that third inning or that fourth inning program. So if you need relief and you need a good one out of that fourth inning pack, you can take this Billy Wagner over the Ripken and the McCutcheon. I took Cal Ripken, but this Billy Wagner, definitely no slouch. Those are the best per nines in the game. Absolutely amazing. Gonna shut absolutely small PCI. He's gonna shut down here. It's 99 velo, 99 break. Control is not terrible, but the four seam slider, curveball, changeup. That is an amazing mix. That's a really, really good mix to have. Four seam, a slider, a curveball, and a changeup. Man, hitters jumping all over the place. Number two on this list, I do believe, is this Kenley Jansen, the new one that came out in the game. He hasn't been out for a while, so I can't put him at number one, but just the way this card looks, I think he will be the best reliever in the game after people start using him, unless he's just a fluke card and people can't hit him. I know people say a lot of things about the live series because he doesn't have a fastball, but this one does have a fastball, so I think this one will just be a lot better to use. And the per nines, again, almost as good as Billy Wagner's, just one hits per nine point off from being as good, but the control is just so much better than Wagner. The velo, the break, I just think I can't put this card at number one because we haven't seen him enough. He's only been out for, a day or two. Can't put that card there. And then coming in at number three, it's very close. You have this Suter, this Gossage. I mean, I love this Goose Gossage card. Here's my stats with this card. He's after 69 and a two-thirds innings. Yeah, 129 ERA and 34 saves for me. He's a beast. He's an absolute beast. But I think I have to go for number three. I'd love to go with this Gossage. I've heard some things about this Sutter, and I don't think it's honestly that amazing. The Kirby Yates looks pretty good. But, I mean, I've heard things about this Sutter, and I would put this at three. From my past experiences, I kind of like this card from VR. But I got to go with this Eric Gagne at number three. It's a tie between him and Eckersley, honestly. Because I haven't used either of these guys. And they both look very, very similar. Eckersley looks better, and he has a better mix. I'm putting Eckersley at number three. And I think, actually, now that I'm looking at all this, I think it's really close, because the stats by far look way better on Eckersley, right? You look at the two attribute wheels, and Eckersley just looked a lot better, but Eric Gagne's pitch mix, a four-seam fastball, 97. Vulcan change, a 70-mile-per-hour curveball, slider, and a splitter. Might be untouchable. So there's that for closing pitchers. Either one of those guys is good, except Gagne selling for 300,000. Actually, 77. So that might change your mind there. And I'm only doing pitchers for this video, so I'm gonna go back to starting pitchers, and I'm just gonna run through some of the budget guys that you can get on your squad that will shut down hitters for you. Nah, the Cyan is selling for 37,000 stubs. And I've had so much trouble hitting this card. I don't know if he's really that good. Everything is just very, very slow on this card. And he's kind of easy to sit back on and hit, except that screwball. It'll throw some guys off. So, I mean, the first time facing Cy Young, the struggle, I just think this card's very hittable. So I would not pick up this card for 37,000 stubs. But I would take this Whitey Ford for 11,000. It's a signature series card. Really good stats, a nice five pitch mix, and he's a lefty. This card's incredible. Only 63 velocity, but the control, the break is very good, and he has two pitches that are over the 90 mile per hour threshold, unlike Cy Young. And he's got that sinker. The sinker breaks into a lefty and breaks away from a righty. So, I mean, that's a really good pitch for him. 11,000. Budget, if you want to consider Max Scherzer budget, I think go for it. I think this card's really, really good. And it can help you get the Nationals collection done. Any live series is better than any flashback, just because for collection reasons. But the Max Scherzer is very good. And then all these guys, it's Nolan Ryan, Seager, Oswalt, and Kerry Wood. Definitely worth looking at, but you get all these guys out of the Diamond XP reward path. You get this card very often during the XP reward pass. So I don't know if you want to spend stubs there. And then the Sheik of DeGrom is the last one I want to look at. This card is really, really shut down on the mound. And he's only selling for 21,000 stubs. So if you have the money, I'd say go for it. And this Rick and Keel too, Signature Series card. How can you pass on a 23,000 stub Signature Series card? And he can hit. He can rake. He's a starting pitcher, five pitch mix, really good pitching stats, and he rakes. The only thing about this card is the control is terrible. So I'd watch out for control there with that card. Now moving on to the relievers. All these golds, all these live series golds are really good. But this Johnny Venters at 3,000, about 4,000 subs, is the best left-handed relief pitcher on this list right here behind Andrew Miller. I mean, this card is absolutely amazing. Look at the stats on this thing, man. The only thing that's lacking really is kind of the control. It's kind of the control a little bit. And an amazing four-pitch mix. I mean, this card is in my bullpen. He's absolutely amazing. So, I mean, take a look at him. Take a look at the live series potentials. Live series potentials has always been alright. Just his control has kind of been a problem for some people that have trouble locating pitches. And then the last one, Andrew Miller is the best one on this list. The inside edge today hurts him. And then you get down to the silvers, and the only one I'm going to say is this Chris Sale. 274,000 stubs. 274 stubs. And this card is literally, the GOAT for silvers. You won't find a better silver card than this. I know I kind of get rocked with this card. But that's because I pitch with this card against the CPU when I just need to give up runs. So there is that, and then we gotta move to closers now. We gotta move on to the closer position. Let's look up some budget ballers. This Kirby Yates, you can pick this card up. I think this card's really good. A splitter and a slider, and then a hard four seam. I don't think you can pass on that. And he's only selling for 5,000 stubs. Inside edge, you can't look at that. But the Pernines are really good on this card. Amazing break, and the control and velocity are not bad. This Kenley Jansen up here obviously is selling for a lot. So if you don't want to get down, you can go ahead and pick up the 87 overall. I know it has a three pitch mix, but those three pitches are really good. Fastball. Oh, he does have a fastball. I mean, I didn't think he had a fastball. The 82 mile per hour slider and the 91 mile per hour cutter. This card's very good for only 18,000 stubs. I would definitely look into it. Next one is this 91 Greg Holland. This card is pretty sick. This card is absolutely nasty. At 11,000 stubs, look at those Pernines. 99 break, a splitter, and a slider with the 90 mile per hour fastball. 81 control with 113 clutch coming out of the bullpen. I mean, I don't know. I don't know if you can look past this card. If you're looking for a good reliever, come out of the pen, that's definitely your guy right there. Is this Greg Holland, 91 overall. I think this is the most budget baller card we have. This ranks 11 out of 10 on the budget baller scale for us. And that is going to end the video for you guys. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you want to see more of these types of videos, leave a like, subscribe to the channel for more. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.